Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about the next topic. Yesterday we have finished with the till the cell wall. Now we are going to study about the next topic, that is plasmolysis. So what is the phenomenon of plasmolysis? As we have studied, like in plant cell, the outer membrane is cell wall. So let us say this is cell wall. This is cell wall. So this is a plant cell. So it contains cell wall as the outer membrane. Then inner side it is what? The plasma membrane. So it is plasma membrane. I am making nucleus also here. Nucleus and I have made even nucleus also. Now in the phenomenon of plasmolysis, what happened? Osmosis occurs, and in osmosis there is loss of water from this cell. Now water will be loosed from this cell. As soon as the water is lost, the plasma membrane got shrinked. It will get shrink. So after some time, what will happen? The condition will be like this. This is the cell wall. Cell wall, as it is the tough part, so it will remain intact. It will not get disturbed due to osmosis. So it will be remain. It will remain intact, cell wall. But what will happen to plasma membrane? It will shrink. So it will shrink like this. So now plasma membrane got shrinked and it is like this now. This process of shrinkage of plasma membrane due to osmosis, that is known as plasmolysis. So you can write down also the shrinkage of, so shrinkage word is important, then plasma membrane, who is going to be shrinked. So plasma membrane is going to shrink. Cell wall will remain intact. So plasma membrane, PM means plasma membrane. This is plasma membrane. Shrinkage of plasma membrane due to osmosis. Okay, due to osmosis, that is plasmolysis. Okay, now moving to the another topic, that is nucleus. So we will discuss about the nucleus. Plasmolysis we have done. Now come to nucleus. So we have in the diagram of the plant cell and the animal cell, we have already seen the structure of nucleus. Can you remember what was the difference about the nucleus in case of plants in an animal cell? Just recall it, what I have told you about the position of nucleus in case of plant cell and animal cell. So you might have recalled that in case of a plant cell, nucleus is somewhat present or shifted towards the periphery, means at the sideways, just because of the presence of large one vacuole. While in case of animal cell, the nucleus is, it is positioned in the center of the cell. This is one of the difference about the nucleus. Now, what is nucleus? What is its structure? Nucleus is a membrane bound structure. Okay, membrane bound means it contains one membrane. So, it is, next topic is nucleus. Okay, so nucleus is a membrane bound structure. Okay, so it is a nucleus. It has some pores also. Pores means hole, from which the genetic material, in the previous video I have also told you what is the genetic material. It may be DNA, it may be RNA. We will discuss it about it later on. So there are some pores through which the genetic material can go outside. of the nucleus. So it is nuclear membrane. This is what? Nuclear membrane. Inside it, one nucleolus is present. What is that nucleolus? This is nucleolus. Okay, and this whole white part is nucleoplasm. Like in a cell, there was cytoplasm. In a nucleus, it is called as nucleoplasm. It means the fluid present in the nucleus. That is nucleoplasm. So, it is nucleoplasm, this white portion. Now, we will discuss about the genetic material. Genetic material is present inside the nucleus. Genetic material is present inside the nucleus. So, it is genetic material. Genetic material may be DNA or RNA. It depends upon whether DNA is there or RNA is there. Like in case of plants and animals, it is DNA. It is DNA in case of plants and animals, while in case of viruses, you might be aware of the viruses. Viruses basically they are non-living particles when they are present outside the host body. Like today, in today's days, you might have been listening about the virus that is coronavirus. So virus basically they are inanimate or they are non-living things. Present in the atmosphere, but as soon as they enter into the host organism, host can be any sort of living organism. It could be human beings, it can be another animal, or it can be plants as well. Any living organism can be the host for the viruses. Even bacteria. Bacteria can also be the host. Host means who is going to provide the nutrition to that virus. So the virus, when it is present outside the body, it is non-living. When it will get inside the host cell, it become living. So here the RNA is the genetic material mostly of the viruses. DNA can also present in viruses. There are some viruses which have a DNA as their genetic material, but there are some viruses whose genetic material is RNA. Okay. So this is the general structure of the nucleus. Now we will move to this genetic material. This genetic material means DNA or RNA. It contains information. Information about all the body things. What is present in your body means your height, your complexion, your eye color, everything. What are the things being produced even in your body? That is just the information is coded by your genetic material. That is DNA. Okay. Now here in the nucleolus, if we find this nucleolus. Nucleolus is again a small portion present inside the nucleus, and it is present in the nucleoplasm as well. So what are the function? There are certain things which are being, the study is being going on for the nucleolus. So it was being found out that nucleolus help in the ribosome formation. It helps in ribosome formation, and it is also rich in proteins. You might be aware of the proteins. And we will discuss it later on about the proteins also. So it contains, it is rich in protein and RNA. Nucleolus is rich in protein and RNA. So there are two things about nucleolus. It is rich in protein and it is rich in RNA. Then nucleoplasm. Nucleoplasm is a fluid which I have already told you. It is a fluid in which all the genetic material is embedded into it. It means the genetic material floats in the nucleoplasm. That is all about the nucleoplasm and the nucleolus. Now come to this genetic material. Genetic material, it's basically the building block is gene, like DNA. DNA is a big unit. How DNA is formed? DNA is formed because of the addition of small units. Those small units are called as genes. Okay, so it is somewhat like this. one gene, then second gene, third, fourth, and so on. So several genes combine together to form a DNA. And it means genes, they are the smallest unit of DNA or heredity or your information. So genes are the structural and functional unit of heredity. You can also learn this definition. So it is the structural and functional unit. Functional unit of heredity. Now this new term comes to you, that is heredity. What is heredity? Heredity means passing the information from one generation to another generation. It means like some of the information has been passed from your mother and father to you. Like sometime you might have seen your face cut that matches with your mother more or to your father more. Sometimes it happens like your height matches that you might have listened at your home. Like somebody's height is according to his father or his mother. Complexion sometimes, face cut. There are different things which we match from our parents. So why we are matching with our parents? Just because of the genes. That genes has been passed from our mother and father to us. That is, the gene is being transferred from one generation to another generation. When new generation will come, your genes will be passed on to the next generation. Okay, now come to the after genes. Next topic will be one more thing is there, that is nucleoid. Okay, so what is nucleoid? For that we have to discuss about prokaryotes and eukaryotes. There are two more technical terms. So first of all, I will tell you about prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Then I will tell you about the nucleoid. That is somewhat related to nucleus, but we will hold on it here. Then we will start after the prokaryotes and eukaryotic cells. Okay, now come to the third part, that is prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So first of all, prokaryotic cell. So what are prokaryotic cells? Those cells which do not possess enveloped nucleus. You have seen that nucleus was enveloped. I have made a diagram of nucleus. But in some organism, this nucleus, the nucleus was containing the genetic material, that was DNA or RNA. So sometimes it happens in some organism that genetic material is non-enveloped. It is not covered by any membrane. So in prokaryotic cell, this is the main thing. The prokaryotic cell, the example of the prokaryotic cell is bacteria. So bacteria is one such cell which do not possess the membrane on the chromatin, that is DNA or RNA, the genetic material. So one important thing is that it possesses non-membrane bound nucleus. And when the nucleus is non-membrane bound, then this nucleus, here it is not called as nucleus, it is called as nucleoid. It is called as nucleoid at that time. It means when the nucleus is non-membrane bound, there is no membrane over the genetic material. You can see this in bacteria. So let's say this is bacteria. Bacteria are variously shaped. I have made here a one bacillus shaped. Here the chromatin material, it is present like this only. It is the bacterial cell. This is the cell wall. Don't think it is a nucleus. It is not a nucleus here. It is cell wall of the bacteria. Now, during this time, as you are sitting at your home, totally packed, you cannot go outside. When you will be coming to us in the school, then I'll tell you how to maintain your biology notebook. At this time, just study this thing. Keep watching our videos for several times. You can see videos and you can gather the information. Just keep it in your mind. You can practice in your rough notebooks, because you not might have the notebooks which are being prepared at your at the school. So then I will tell you how to maintain biology notebook. At that time I will tell you. So here bacteria. This is bacteria. Inside it several organelles are there. I am not making them. Here it is nucleoid. This is nucleoid. Why nucleoid? This is the correct spelling of nucleoid. So why nucleoid? Because it is not covered with any membrane. Okay. So that is nucleoid. Nucleoid is present in bacteria. When its function is same. It means it controls your all the info. It contain all your information. Nucleoid as well. Its definition is much important. You have to learn its definition. What is nucleoid? Nucleoid is uncovered or non-membrane bound nucleus present in the prokaryote. What is nucleoid? It is non-membrane bound nucleus present in the prokaryotes. At that time, we will not call it nucleus. We will call it nucleoid. Now, there is one type of this cell that is prokaryote. Another type of cell is eukaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell. Now, what is special in the eukaryotic cell? Eukaryotic cell contains nucleus. It means they have their genetic material covered with the membrane, and that genetic material, when it is covered with the membrane, it is known as nucleus. Okay, so what is the speciality in the eukaryotic cell? That it contains membrane bound nucleus. Focus on the word non. And here membrane bound nucleus is present. Now there are several other differences. I am writing down about the differences between the prokaryotes and the eukaryotic cell. So hope you are understanding about what is nucleoid, as these are new terms to you. There are several other differences of the eukaryotic and the prokaryotic cell. I am writing down every point here, and we will discuss it here also. Prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. Okay, let us talk about the size first of all. Can you see bacteria with your eyes? So your answer will be no. Okay. It means we cannot see the bacteria with our naked eyes. It means naked means without any microscope. Now, as the size is very less, so you must be learning about what is the approximate size of a prokaryotic cell. So, size of a prokaryotic cell is approximately 1 to 10 micrometer. Okay. So, its size is about 1 to 10. This is the symbol of micro. Micrometer, and 1 micrometer is equals to 10 to the power minus 6 meters. It is micro. Okay. Then what is the size of a eukaryotic cell? So eukaryotic cell, basically it is quite large, and it contains, what is the size? The size will be approximately 5 to 100. Size will be 5 to 100 micrometer. Okay. Now, second thing. As we have talked about the nucleus. So, nucleus in case of prokaryote, it contains an undefined nucleus. Undefined, why we are saying undefined? It means it do not possess any kind of cell membrane. Okay. So, it contains undefined nucleus. undefined region which contains non-membrane bound nucleus. Okay, so prokaryotic cell, it does not contain nucleus, it contains nucleoid, that is nucleoid. Whereas in this, it contains defined region of nucleus. Okay, now come to prokaryotic, another difference that we have discussed about the genetic material. That whole genetic material is also known as chromosome. Learn it here only. Like that whole genetic material, it is also known as chromosome. You will later on study the structure of chromosome. But here you have to learn that the genetic material, that is also known as chromosome. So in case of prokaryote, chromosome is single, means only one, single chromosome. While it has many chromosomes. The last difference about the prokaryotic and the eukaryotic cell is, like in case of prokaryotic cell, the nucleus was non-membrane bound. It means it does not contain any membrane. Likewise, the cell organelles are also non-membrane bound in case of prokaryotic cell. So, cell organelles are non-membrane bound. Whereas in case of eukaryotes, the cell organelles are membrane bound. Okay, so these are four differences. Learn them and you will be recalling these points about the eukaryotic and prokaryotic. You can learn one more point about the differences. Like one example you can say, example bacteria. Here eukaryotic mein example animal cell. Plant cell, because both animal cell and plant cell, they contain this nucleus, that's why they are eukaryote. Okay, now come to another topic. We have finished with nucleus, then we have finished with prokaryotes and eukaryote. Now coming to the next topic, that is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm, again, it is a fluid and all the contents are present inside the, means they are all the components, cell organelles are embedded inside the cytoplasm. What was the fluid present in the nucleus called as? Just recall it so that you can give the answer yourself. So the answer you have given is nucleoplasm. So the fluid present in the nucleus is called as nucleoplasm. That's why you can say, you can learn, the fluid present in the cell is cytoplasm. So we are going to study about cytoplasm. Like this is a cell. All the area is present here is known as cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is a fluid. So when fluid is present, this is known as cytoplasm. It is a fluid. Okay, it contains all the cell organelles in it. So it contains cell organelles. Okay, it contains all the cell organelles. Now, important thing here is the viruses. Talking about viruses, they are non-living outside the host cell. Means if it is not present in our body, it is a non-living thing. As soon as it enters in our body, it becomes living. That virus that virus also do not possess any kind of cytoplasm. When it get inside the host body, it multiplies itself very fastly and it used our system to get multiplied. It do not use any system of its own because it does not have anything except its genetic material. All the things are being used by our cell only. Now coming to the next topic, that is the cell organelles. Here you can recall one more thing, like a cell. The cytoplasm of the cell, basically it contains approximately 70 or 80% of water. It contains lots of water inside it, the cytoplasm. Now you can recall one thing, any cell, it comprises of membrane, then cell cytoplasm, and inside the cytoplasm it contains cell organelles. So now we have to discuss about this thing. Only this thing is left. There are several examples of cell organelles. I am telling you what are the different cell organelles present in a cell. So first is the ER. ER means endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum. It is of two type, rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Why they are called as rough and smooth, we will discuss it later on. Second example is ribosomes. Third example, it's chloroplast, then lysosomes, then mitochondria, then chloroplast is done, lysosomes, mitochondria, ribosomes, chloroplast, the types of chloroplast we will discuss later on. Endoplasmic, I think one more is left. ER, ribosome, chloroplast, lysosomes, then mitochondria. One more is left, we will discuss it later on. Okay, we will discuss it later on if one or two is left. So these are some of the cell organelles present in your cell. We will take one by one and we will also discuss their function. In which cell they are present? Are they present in eukaryotic cell, prokaryotic cell? Are they present in plant cell or animal cell? That we also have discussed previously. Okay, so we will discuss in the next video the function of all these cell organelles. Okay, thank you guys. Next we will I will upload the next video and then we will see the functions of these cell organelles. Okay, thank you so much.